G'day everybody, welcome to Distant Date Night, coming live from Candaloo, New South Wales, Australia. tonight I have some special guests for you, woo! So I'm about to introduce you. Ready, spaghetti? I've added you in. Okay, there you are. Introducing Roger and Dobe from the Bushwackers.
Hey!
Hello!
Hi, everybody. Hi. Hey, thank you, Melanie, for having us on your show tonight.
Yeah. it's like being transported into deepest, darkest Candaloo on a nice Saturday eve.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to play a song to warm everybody up, and I'll see you all soon, okay?
Okay.
Cool. All right, see you in a second. Oh, now I've got to remember what to start with. I'm actually going to start with the New Graces one, one of the songs I wrote for the Graces. Ready? Some men. I'm going to take these off. Hang on. I'm trying to be glamorous and professional, but I still am a bit wobbly. Ready? Some. Like a storm, some men are cold like the wind, but you, the gentlest of men, are gone like the rain, a warm summer skin, and I'm gonna let you love me.
Why can't you write songs like that? We might go home now.
No. That's a big old soppy love song, you know.
Big soppy love songs. Oh, God. Love big soppy love songs.
There's a few people have tuned in. We've got a couple of mates have popped in there. There's Lindsay's hopped in and...
Oh, really? Cool.
Sam Phillips is there. And
yay. Hi, Sam.
The Water Runners have popped in. There you go. The troops. Everyone's in. Listening in tonight. Nice.
Jeff Sharon Horsnell.
That's mum and dad.
Is that your dad?
Yeah, dad.
You've got to depend on your mum and dad to listen in, don't you?
Yeah, yeah. They'll report back saying, Melanie, you're too loud or you're too quiet or something or other.
Well, that's what Sam sort of does for us too. She's listening in and she's going to respond and tell me if we're being stupid or not. So, is it me to play now?
It's you to play now, yeah. We're passing that. What? Actually, so I should just reintroduce because, you know, that's what I said I'd do, but I'm
just
reintroducing Roger and Dobe from the Bushwackers.
All right. Well, I'm going to play a song, Dobe, first of all.
Oh, no.
Have to explain the action. Yeah. I mean, you answer. It's your Melanie.
Just quick question. If I'm going to play along with Rog, do I unplug the headphones and plug in the other bit, or can I just go now?
Just stay where you are.
All right. Okay, cool.
As you were, Dave.
It's only when we pass to you next that you're going to have to do the little fandangle manoeuvre.
Yes, I should explain that Dobe is in Melbourne, and I'm here in lovely downtown Lawn near Maitland, and through the magic of, and you're in Candelo, aren't you, Melanie?
Yeah, here we go. We're transported through the screen like Willy Wonka style.
What are you going to do, Rog?
Well, I thought I'd start off with a bit of a bush song, Dobe, so I just I figured that would be good. It's going to be Jog Along Till Shearing.
Oh, excellent.
Just start with a bit of a classic.
Yeah.
Are you ready now? You going to keep quiet?
Yeah, no, I'm ready.
Okay, that's good. Here we go.
Don't laugh, I'm just trying to work out how to put just two of you on there.
All right.
Go for it.
Two, three, four. I'm counting us in, like as if we're playing in a band. Song so clear, without a word of gammon. Swaggy travels all the year, waiting for the lamb. When his dirty work is done, and the nearest shanty steering, they meet old friends, their money spenders, jog along till shearing comes. Home sweet home, that is what they left it for, their home sweet home. Now when the shearing season comes, hear the price that's going. New arrivals meet old chums, then they start their blowing. They reckon they can shear each day 100 pretty handy. 80 sheep is bloody hard, where the water's close and sandy. And it's home sweet home, that's what they left for their home sweet home. Well, when the sheds are all cut out, they get their bit of paper. Off to the nearest pub they run, the cup to dash and caper. They've got all the liquor plenty, they're happy when they're drinking. Where they'll go when the money's gone, it's little ale we're thinking about. So sweet home, that is what they left it for, their home sweet home. Little sick and sore next morning, they are when they wake up. Have another drink, they must keep their nerves from shaking. Call for one and then for two, in a way that's rather funny. Till the landlord says, now this won't do, you men have got no money. Home sweet home, that is what they left it for, their home sweet home. Well, they're leaning on veranda posts, loafing on the sofas, or to finish off their spree, ordered off as loafers. Got no friends, their money's gone, and they're disappearing. It's three cheers for the riverbed, then jog along to shearing. Home sweet home, that's what they left it for, their home sweet home. You go jog along till shearing. So the thing with all these shearing songs is that shearers used to go along and jump into the shearing sheds and wander around the country and get till they got a job, and then they'd get a payout, and then they all go to the pub and drink the whole lot and then do it all again. So all our songs on one of our albums all like that. Lazy Harry's and jog along to shearing. Anyway, Ryback Shearer, they're all just about shearing and drinking. So I don't know what anybody else did back then, but that was about it. The 1880s.
Well, you know, joy of life, huh?
That's right. I'm not sure how much joy there was in it.
What do you say? You can't take it with you. You may as well drink it up anyway.
That's right, yeah. So, yes, that's a pretty classic Bushwacker song off one of our very first records, but also we've re-recorded a lot of these songs, so that's how that goes.
Yeah, cool. We're going to do our pass to Dobe now.
Okay, uh-oh. Look out. Oh.
Uh-oh.
This is pretty exciting, Dobe. What are you planning to sing, Dobe?
Actually, here's a question for you. We've got...
Has anyone in the Bushwackers ever sheared a sheep?
Well, I tried.
I've got a poodle, if that counts.
No, I had
a... Tell you what, I think I'd rather shear a sheep than try to shear my dog, I tell you now.
Yeah, yeah.
That is hard work.
No, I had a go, and I wasn't very successful.
Did you cut yourself, Dobe?
No, not the sheep, though.
Oh, you cut the sheep a bit, didn't
you? But not seriously. It wasn't a matter of calling for tar. It was a slight graze. But
slight graze, yes.
Yeah, yeah. No.
You realised shearing wasn't for you, Dobe? Is that what happened?
Oh, yeah, no. It was just... It gigged in the country, and we were watching people shear, and somebody said, look, have a go. And I went, oh, yeah, all right. No, it wasn't.
No, I can't imagine you shearing a sheep. You could frighten them so they would drop their wool, Dobe. Somebody here, Sam says our youngest band member, that's Rory. G'day, Rory. He's got self-shedding dorpers, whatever they are. Sheep.
That's clever enough.
I think they're sheep.
Sheep that the wool falls off. Yeah, they shed themselves.
Yeah, but
yeah, that's right.
Have you got Shane's?
Well, where's the fun in that?
There's a comment from Shane there.
Blew the power at Birkenhead Point with Flash Jack. Oh, that's right, because that's our first song, so must have been good. Sam, I know they're
all right, Dobe, we're ready for you.
All right, Dobe, good.
Go on. So unplug your headphones and go for the speakers.
Well, yeah, but I've got to know what I'm supposed to do so I can...
Okay, why don't you start with digging for gold, Dobe, and I'll introduce you if you like. While you muck around.
All right.
Okay, yeah, so this is our... Right. This was a song that we wrote this year. Dobe had this idea about because it's our golden anniversary, because we've been going for 50 years. And Dobe said, all this time, it's been our golden anniversary and we've been searching for gold, like golden guitars, and it's our golden anniversary, so we should have a song about gold. So I ignored him, as I usually do, and then a few weeks later, I woke up after having a dream, and this song wrote itself in my brain. So so this is a collaboration with a few people, but mostly me, I guess, and Dobe's idea. So this is called Digging for Gold. I'm going to play the banjo. You can mute me, Mel, if you want.
Yep. Okay, that means you're talking, Dobe. Are you there, Dobe? Almost. we're doing a very fandangled stream tonight, so it's oh, here we go. Look, this is going to work now. Rock and roll. Go, Dobe.
It's
going to
work now. Rock and roll. Go, Dobe.
We came out here in 81. Take a lot of reasons. Digging in the river, get paid. Found a nugget on the second day. Built a little place, we were there to We worked at Grinders Plant. Tea and bed. Trade the river we just knew. Stayed the course and saw it through. Digging for gold. River runs fast, river runs wild. Thousand came to make that. Only a few the extra mile. The river runs deep, the river runs cold. Once we're young, but now we're old. The carbon name on a rock, I'm told. Digging for gold. Demon diggers went. He grew on that bend. Empires built should came. We worked hard, it's our claim. Down through the years we've made our name. For gold. The river runs far, the river runs wild. Thousand came to make their pile. Only you and the extra mile. And the river runs deep, the river runs cold. We once were young, now we're old. The company rock, I'm told. Digging for gold. Treasure in the river would go deep. A golden dream still haunts my sleep.
Fire in the belly from deep inside.
Nothing's gained if nothing's tried. When you're digging for gold. The river runs fast, the river runs wild. Thousands came to make their pile. Only a few went the extra mile. And the river runs deep, the river runs cold. We once yeah, but now we're old. I carve your name on a rock and roll. Like the old pioneers who went digging for gold. Digging for gold, digging for gold. Dig for gold, digging for gold. Digging for gold.
Your internet's a bit all over the place there, Uncle Dobe.
He might be able to hear you just yet.
Okay. All right.
We'll round him up in a second.
Yeah, I think his internet's pretty bad, Melanie. So,
and I think too, like, if don't laugh, but if someone else in the house is streaming a movie, you've got to tell them to stop streaming for the next hour.
Yeah, that's right. Can you hear me, Dobe? Yes, he's a bit.
That's right. We'll go.
I'll send him.
We'll go back around. Oh yeah, it's gone. It's frozen now. Oh, there he is again. We've lost him. Come on. Where's my mic? It's frozen. All right. Well, I'll play a song. And
Sam's got a message.
Yeah, I was sending her a message too.
Okay, good.
You
sign in, Mel. I'll sing some more.
All right, I'll sing something and I'll come back around. What was I going to do next? Well, actually, I was actually going to try something. This is probably not the best time to try something, but I was going to try playing a Slim Dusty one.
Okay.
Maybe I won't do it this for a second. I'll pull my. Hang on. Take that off. And I'll hop onto the screen solo and I'll let you guys chat to each other. Okay, see you in a second. All right. So I thought I'd try. Slim's Looking Forward, Looking Back. I've got to pick the right key, so looking forward. There it is. It's always best to pick an unknown song, second one up, but it's all right. Ready, spaghetti? I'll give it a go. Looking forward. I've come a long way down the track. I've got a long way left to go, making songs from what I know, making sense from what I've seen. Thank you. There you all are.
Oh, yes.
Hello. Okay.
That's good. That's great. We're,
I didn't realize I accidentally left you all on the screen. Sorry.
It's all right. I smiled and tried not to do anything embarrassing on the way through. It's good.
Well, what are you going to sing for us, Roger?
Okay, I'll do another song, I guess. So, Dobe's going to try pairing to his phone because I think his internet's a bit up the wazoo. So,
actually, that was I was going to suggest that to him. So that's what I do when it's dodgy. So, yeah. Go forth, Roger. What are you going to play?
Go forth. Come forth. It's weird because we've got a mirror image. So if I... Yeah. I have to go opposite. this is a song I wrote a while ago with Alan Caswell. Do you know Alan?
Yeah.
So Alan's... I've known Alan for nearly 40 years and we... get together every now and again and write a song or two. So we wrote this one together. This is called Leave It in the Ground. It's about, because I've moved to Maitland and we have a never-ending stream of coal trains going past our door.
Yeah.
Down to, I think, is Newcastle the biggest coal port in the Southern Hemisphere or something? Coal loading port? It's just terrible.
Yeah.
Just breaks my heart, really, every time I see it. But anyway, we wrote this song. And it's called Leave It in the Ground.
Groovy.
Good to go?
Yep, ready to roll.
Well, you can't eat coal, you can't breathe gas. Sell it out the country for a pile of cash. Well, you get it up and ship it out wherever it can be found. And send it off to China, leave it in the ground. They send it off to China, leave it in the ground. Well, I'm lying in bed, listening to the coal trains in the night. Well, I meet the multinational bottom line. By the time it's on the water, we've already lost the fight. Now children are the victims of the crime. There's hours and miles of farming land that's gone under the knife. Well, another rural family lose their land. We're driving them to death and fear and pain and suicide. The truth is that their blood is on our hands. Well, you can't eat coal and you can't breathe gas. Selling out the country for a pile of cash. We're digging it up and shipping it out wherever it can be found. And send it off to China, leave it in the ground. And send it off to China, leave it in the ground. Well, they're fracking here, they're fracking there, just like they own the joint. The government has given them the right. Election funding guarantee, that's a bloody point. Don't know how those bastards sleep at night. Well, you can't eat coal and you can't breathe gas. Selling out the country for a pile of cash. We're digging it up and shipping it up wherever it can be found. Send it off to China, leave it in the ground. Can't send it off to China, leave it in the ground. Well, the landscape is a moonscape. The scenery is shot. Your coal dust poison floating on the breeze. The aquifers are dying. They're ruining the crop. We've got to put an end to this disease. Cause you can't eat coal and you can't breathe gas. You're selling out the country for a pile of cash. They're digging it up, shipping it out, and it can be found. Send it off to China, leave it in the ground. Oh, you can't eat coal, you can't breathe gas. Selling out the country for a pile of cash. They're digging it up and shipping it out wherever it can be found. And send it off to China, leave it in the ground. And send it off to China, leave leave it in the ground, please.
Woo!
Yes.
Oh.
Hi, Dobe. You're back.
Oh, I'm back. All right. Oh.
Oh, you look fancier.
Yes, you look a bit more high, a bit more high res, Dobe.
Oh.
Yes.
Really? Okay. All right.
Did
sorry
you
about
switch
all that.
You switch your rooted over? Oh, it's just
yeah,
normal.
I know.
Mum and Dad chimed in. See, look, look, that's better, Dobe. Oh no, that's John. G'day, John. Great song, Roger.
Thank you very much, John.
Mum and Dad said that's better, Dobe. See, there you go.
I can't see any of our fans on there, but you know, if they're on there, you should give us a shout out and say hello.
And also, some of the people won't show up in the stream, and we can write back to them later and tell them funny things. Yeah. Well, that was cool. Like, it's a cracker song, man. Yeah.
Oh, thank you. We've been playing it a long time, and sometimes, you know, playing it around here, some people get annoyed because there's a lot of coal workers in the Hunter Valley. But, you know, it's not about them. It's just about that, you know, it's ridiculous, as we all know.
It's like... The change of mindset to what we can make next. Like, my brother works with renewable energy in England, and it's, you know, coal mine workers could then go towards that sort of stuff, you know. They could keep working but just move to a different industry. So
I think everyone will stop using it pretty soon, and that's because when we first started doing that about 4 years ago, it was pretty like, ooh, that's a bit controversial, and not so much now, I think, anyway.
You're talking to a person who lives in, I live in a solar house, off-grid. So
completely off-grid. Wow, that's good.
Completely off-grid. So I've got two candles behind this computer screen.
Just in case the power goes out. You're in candle-o, so that's probably why.
Yeah. All right, Dobe, are you ready to rock?
Oh no, I've got to do this thing again.
All right.
Well, hopefully it'll be a bit better this time, Dobe.
Steady. What are we going to do?
It was pretty crap
last
time, so. Yeah.
Oh, excuse you. What are we going to do now, Rudd?
All right. I've got a song list for you, Dobe.
Yes.
Here we go. Let's try Dirt Under My Nails this time.
All right. Well, it would have been good if you'd let me know beforehand, but never mind. All right. So I'm
bastard.
I know. Well, no. I mean, honestly, I'm unplugging this one now, and then I'll plug in the other one, and I'll start it.
All right.
All right.
Okay.
Stop laughing.
It's through the miracle of technology that we're going to go to do this.
Oh,
so.
God. All right. Okay.
He's so high tech, really. You know.
Okay.
We're ready, so you can. Okay. Oh, did you unplug your headphones and put your speaker on?
Now I've got to start it again.
Good boy, though.
Wait a minute.
You're in control, though.
Yeah. All right.
The long man ever knew.
Years come too quick and the kids they grew. I know I'm old and my mind is slow. I paid my dues those years ago. We did the very best work that we could. And we worked every day both hard and good. Said our prayers and we paid our debts. I sit right here with few regrets. With the dirt under my nails I built. The dirt under my nails. I built a home for my family with the dirt under my nails. Came down under after World War II. There was no work back home for us to do. Up north I cut sugarcane for 3 years. Sent the money back home to get my girl down here. Didn't meet my son till he was 4 years old. And I swore I'd never let him go hungry or cold. I carried that concrete on my back. And I swore then I was gonna make my mark. And we saved every penny and we bought a home. And with the Italian work ethic paid off the loan. In only 9 years I've proven my worth. A homeowner on the other side of the earth. I built with the dirt under my nails. I built the dirt under my nails. I built a home for the family with the dirt under my nails. With the dirt under my nails, I built the dirt under my nails. I built a home for the family with the dirt under my nails. All right. Grandkids, they fill me with pride. Sons and daughters turned out all right. They take me for a walk when the weather's fair. I spend most of my time sitting in my chair. And I tell them tales of the world long past. And the years that seem to fly so fast. I tell them of my sacrifice. And I tell them of the wonderful life I lived. With the dirt under my nails, I built the dirt under my nails. I built a home for the family with the dirt under my nails. With the dirt under my nails, I built with the dirt under my nails. Built a home for the family with the dirt under my nails. With the dirt under my nails, I built with the dirt under my nails. I built a home for the family with the dirt under my nails. With the dirt under my nails, I built with the dirt under my nails. I built a home for the family with the dirt under my nails. I built a home for my family with the dirt under my nails.
That was heaps better, Dave.
Hang on, I'm not with you.
Well, we can hear you already.
Right. I'll meet you a second. I'll meet you for a second.
Oh.
So in the middle of that, my power went off. So you know, go the candle power.
Oh my God! Candle-o's living up to its name.
Yeah, that was wicked dope. Hang on, I've got you ready.
I'm here now.
Hey, oh, awesome.
Oh, thanks.
That song was written by Rich Davies, actually. Do you know Rich Davies and the Low Road?
No. Oh, yes, I do. Yes.
Yeah, he's fantastic, yeah.
Yeah, he is fantastic. Oh, that's a cracker.
Yeah, he wrote that song and I had to ring him up and say, could we record that song, please? It's so good. And Dobe sings it so beautiful. So. It is.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Good combo.
Sam's asking, do you have candle-powered internet? So, yes, that's true.
Ha ha.
That's a
no,
joke.
I've just put my child on the bicycle.
See, I think you're joking, but, you know, you're actually not, eh?
So, Mel.
Yep.
Oh.
Are we allowed to call you Mel, or do we have to call you Melanie?
Mel's all right. All right.
Oh, okay. All right. But that song was written as a part of... So Rich is, I'm in Northcote in Melbourne, and Rich is a nearby neighbour. And a few years ago, Northcote had a songwriter's, I don't know what you call it, workshop sort of thing. So they gave everybody a photo and asked them to write a song based on the photo, and Rich was given a photo which was about a bunch of Italian immigrants who'd come out here to work on the Snowy River scheme, and that was the song he wrote, which was
It's cracker.
It's a beautiful, beautiful song. Yeah.
Fabulous song.
And we hardly ever record, you know, cover versions of other people's songs, mainly because we've got Roger, who's marvellous and writes incredible songs.
You're a sarcastic old bastard.
No, I am not. I am not. But no, that was heartfelt.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. But it is
that thing, isn't it? Like,
but there have been, you know, there are a couple of occasions. I mean, somebody reminded me today of Shoalhaven Man, which was a song written by Jeff Drummond, brother of Pat Drummond, which is an astonishingly wonderful song. And every now and again you encounter those songs which you think are absolutely aligned with what we're about. And it doesn't happen often, but that last one was one of them. And
although we do get lots of songs sent to us every now and again.
Yeah, and they're crap, aren't they, Rog?
Well, it makes you wonder whether they've ever actually listened to us playing. Or heard anything we do.
I know.
But it's very nice. And I'm always very polite. Very polite, you know, to them.
Yeah.
And say...
I just reckon sometimes... I think people sometimes are shy of their own voices and things. But I think something is so yummy about them. It doesn't matter if they've got a... You know, I think they should have a go at having a sing of it because, you know... A husky voice or an interesting voice is always just great. Just go for it if you write a song, I reckon. Those people who are sending the songs in, they should just
record it. I think they should too. Yeah. I love hearing them, and I always get back to them and say, you know, well, look, this might not be quite right for us, but send it to the New Graces because it's right up their alley. That's what I'm
saying. I might
play a Sarah Storer one.
Oh, yeah. She's a very special friend of ours, Tim.
You know, if we're going to go beauties of songs, I quite like, I was a bit in love with this one, Karajong Tree. I saw a Karajong Tree recently and then I couldn't get out of my head, so I'll play that one.
Okay.
See you in a second.
Okay.
Oh, there's me. Oh, no, that's for you. All right. Okay, you can all see me in my glowy little space. I'm still glittery. I put on my fancy outfit tonight because I knew I was playing a fancy show. Rory said, all right, I won't send you anymore. All right.
I'm named after my grandmother. My gift is music and hers is poetry. And she told me this story. And with my music, I'd like to sing you
Again.
Beautiful. Very nice, Mel. Gorgeous.
Thank you.
We love Sarah. Well, we've known her for a very long time since she started.
Yeah, so, yep.
Yeah. She came to the academy, or what was then the college, and just after she'd just started, really, and introduced her to Garth Porter, and then the rest was history, and she got signed to ABC and became a big star. Almost overnight, it was amazing.
Yeah, I met her. I was hanging out at Garth's studio.
Right.
All that when he just came back and said, "I found this girl," you know, like.
Oh really?
Oh, wow. I was sort of, yeah. Funnily enough, Garth had come to the Bondi Wave, like, you know, the songwriting thing, and yep. I'd played him a song, and he'd liked the song, and so he said, "All right, if you want, you can come and hang out at the studio." So I ended up just, like, I don't know, every week or several times a week I'd turn up at his studio and just sit quietly in the corner and sometimes bring them coffee and sort of hide but watch how everything worked, you know?
Yeah.
And... yeah, just watch out. And so that's it was just the time, just as he found
Sarah.
You know,
wow.
It was the time that, yeah. Sarah played him a song, right? Yeah, yeah. So
yeah,
so
yeah. I was right there when she played him, cool. A song, and his eyebrows nearly shot off his forehead, and it was so charming and so gorgeous. All those early songs, Buffalo Bill, and all those things.
Yeah,
it's gorgeous.
I love that record. Well, yeah, go did. Forth. Roger, what do you got for us?
All right. Oh, I'm going to put my harmonica back on. So.
Oh.
Rigmarole. Well, actually, no, I'll do a slow song. I'll do our new song, if you like. So I don't know if you can see.
Oh, yeah, we could.
Oh.
Oh, no, this is without me.
This is without you. Yeah. It's just,
oh.
You don't get to be.
You can dance, Dobe.
So this song was. So this lagerphone here has been a part of our lives. Well, the lagerphone in general. We've got about 20 of the things dotted around the country in bits and pieces. But it's been a part of our life because When you're playing the Bushwackers, especially if you're a new musician, and you're standing there minding your own business, playing guitar or something like that, then Dobe starts banging on the stage with this massive lagerphone. So this thing weighs a ton, the lagerphone here. And yeah, it's absolutely massively heavy, and the whole stage will shake, and all the mics will fall over, and something's buzzing quite badly now. I don't know who that is. Anyway, I'll give this song go. So I thought I'd write a song about the lagerphone. And this is about how to make it and everything. It's also about Dobe too. We good to go? It's called The Lagerphone. You take a 35mm piece of dowel, Tassie oak is best. And you trim it down to size, it should come up to your chest. Hammer on a brass sleeve halfway up the pole. It's gonna be a while. Getting to the good part. Take a couple of lengths of plank and fix them to the shaft. 80mm bolts should do it if you make the wing nuts fast. Gonna get you a good drill and make a lot of holes. Still gonna be a while. Getting to the good parts. It's a weapon, it's an instrument, it's a symbol of the art. It's the muscle and the bones, the bush band's beating heart. It's the sweat and it's the fire, it's the spirit and the drive. But when you pick up a lagerphone, the music comes alive. You're gonna need a lot of bottle tops, but don't drive yourself to drink. Get some screws and brass washers so they'll rattle and they'll clink. Make a 10mm hole in every single one. Getting real close now to the good part. It's a weapon, it's an instrument, it's a symbol of the art. It's a muscle and the bones, it's a bush band's beating heart. It's a sweat, it's a fire, it's a spirit and the drive. When you pick up a lagerphone, the music comes alive. Well, he's made a lot of bottle tops. That's where he's made a lot of lagerphones. He's played a lot of shows. From Darwin down to Tassie, from Broome to Dorigo, and I can bring songs all night if you can make them go. It's his weapon, it's his instrument, it's a symbol of his art. It's his muscle and his bones, the whacker's beating heart. It's his sweat, it's his fire, it's his spirit and his drive. The window picks up the lagerphone. Yeah, window picks up the lagerphone. Yeah, window picks up the lagerphone. The music comes alive. Take a 35mm piece of dowel, Tassie oak.
Woo! There we are.
Heard the woo woo. How did you go, Dobe? You okay? Having a song written about you?
It's
nice.
It's a lovely, lovely thing.
Well, Yes, my wife wasn't very happy.
Lindsay's
that I
asked a question.
Does the recorded version of this excellent song, The Lagerphone, actually have a lagerphone in it? No, thankfully not. It would have ruined it.
No, but
but it's got the spirit of the lagerphone in there.
When I first heard it, Lindsay, it was really weird because it's the first Bushwackers song in 49 years that I haven't been a part of. And but Roger's wife Amanda summed it up perfectly because she said, at last Roger's written a love song just not for his wife.
Yes. Normally all our love songs are about sheep, so you know that's... Oh, now somebody's buzzing. I don't know if you can hear that. So.
Yeah.
I can't hear the buzzing at all, but might be just me giggling.
Oh no! Stopped.
No, oh, I can't.
Stopped.
Was that you, Dobe?
No.
I think it's my phone next to the microphone.
Secret,
you know. Dad said we're all hilarious.
That's our new single, you know. And we're hoping people play it on the radio and stuff like that. But, yeah, it's just a nice song. We actually just write songs just so our fans will like them. And, you know, if we get some great airplay, it's good. But it's just nice for the people who already like us to like our songs. So that's why we do songs like that. So it's good.
Yeah.
Hmm.
So, Mum heard you know, buzzing.
When you've been going 50 years there with the New Graces, you'll all be writing songs about each other too.
Oh, it's nice. It's like I heard a lady on Twitter once and she was complaining. She said, oh, I've gone out with this guy and he's a musician and then he wrote a song about me. Can I sue him?
Can you sue him?
Because it was like obviously a breakup song or something. I thought, geez, oh, like, right. Woman, nobody knows that it's about you except you.
Yeah.
But, you know, Dobe's one's much nicer than that.
Yes.
Well, I don't say he's a good bloke in it or anything like that.
No.
I just say he makes a racket, you know, with the lagerphone.
Yeah.
All right, Dobe, what are you going to do for us?
Yes, I don't know. What are you going to do? Oh, well, look, what have we got? What about you do a bit of I Am Australian? Oh, actually, let's have a fast one. Let's do the Lachlan Tigers, Dobe.
Oh, right. Okay. All right.
You think you'll be okay with this one?
Yeah. So
you've been practicing for weeks, I know. So
yeah, you've just got to bear with me while because I don't play anything, well, apart from the said lagerphone.
And they whistle and things that go bang.
Yeah, I know, but nothing melodic. So I've got to disengage this one and plug in the other one.
And I sent myself down to Dobe, you see,
Exactly. So bear with me for a moment.
Okay, well, you should know this song
tell a story.
Anyway.
Yeah. All right, so I'll just unplug this one, plug in the other one, and away we'll go.
It's very high tech. You can tell how tech Dobe is, can't you?
All right.
I think he's done brilliantly.
Yeah, he's all over it, I reckon. Yeah. Very good.
Remember your amp on Dobe? Okay, you're going to take it back to the beginning.
At each Katie Shearer stood as a whistle loudly blew. Eyebrows fixed and lips compressed and tigers all bed too. He could hear the clicking of the shears as through the wool they glide. See a gun already turned is on the weapon side. A lot of luck the Tigers, it's plain to see we are. Hark to a burly ringer as he loudly calls for tar. Tar, here calls one, quick the tar boy flies. Sweep those locks away, another loudly cries. The scene, it is a mighty one, it ought to be admired. There hasn't been a better board since Jackie Howe expired. Along the border, Gaffer walks, face still in a frown. Passing by the ringer says, you watch me lads keep down. You know I must keep the bellies off, top knots too likewise. Me eyes quick, so none of your tricks are from you a fly. Curses on our Gaffer, he's never on our side. Shear a decent tally boys, in vain I've ever tried. A lot of luck the Tigers, it's plain to see we are. Hark to a burly ringer as he loudly calls for tar. Tar, here calls one, quick the tar boy flies. Sweep those locks away, another loudly cries. Oh yeah! A pair of warden panes that are both bright and new. I'll have you in and I'll tell you what we really do. For I shear on the river in where they shear on by the score. Such a tally as Sister Clem I never saw before. A lot of luck for Tigers, it's plain to see we are. Hark to our burly ringer as he loudly calls for tar. Tar, here calls one, quick the tar boy flies. Sweep those locks away, another loudly cries. A lot of luck for Tigers, it's plain to see we are. Hark to our burly ringer as he loudly calls for tar. Tar, here calls one, quick the tar boy flies. Sweep those locks away, another loudly cries. Hey, hey, hey! Lot of luck the Tigers, it's plain to see we are. Hark to our burly ringer as he loudly calls for tar. Tar, here calls one, quick the tar boy flies. Sweep those locks away, another loudly cries. A lot of luck the Tigers, it's plain to see we are. Hark to our burly ringer as he loudly calls for tar. Tar, here calls one, quick the tar boy flies. Sweep those locks away. Another loudly cries.
Yay! Awesome! That was gold!
Yay, Dobe! Very good, Dobe. Oh, yeah.
Oh, wrong plug.
Sam Phillips says, hey.
Actually, here's Sam's been putting up the link for Lagerphone.
Oh yeah, for the song. Yes, so, you can listen to it on the listen to it on the something on can
all the streaming things.
Yes.
Gosh, this is very difficult. The plugging in the different things. Sorry.
Oh, Dad,
you're rocking at it though.
Was that all right?
Oops, that was.
I think you're going very well, Dave.
That was golden.
Oh, good. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Yeah, it was especially good because you knew that one. So when I first, when I used to go and see the Bushwackers back in the day, so I didn't join the band till like 1980 because I was too young. So I'm very much younger than Dave.
And
I said go and see them at this little pub called Polaris and various other places, and then I just, you know, I saw them all over. But Dobe used to play that song in a tiger suit, actually. He used to get dressed up as a
wicked
tiger.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In costume.
Yeah.
In fact, they all used to wear costumes from time to time, didn't you guys?
Yes. Love a dress up.
Yeah, Dobe's never got over it.
Yes.
But he hasn't. the tiger suit hasn't come back. But Dobe, I think this might be the year. What do you reckon at Tamworth?
Yeah, why not?
Yes.
Bring back the tiger, I say.
Yeah.
We'll do the Lagerphone song and you can walk off and then you can come back on in the tiger suit.
All right. Okay.
It's or perhaps a just a tiger suit jacket for the lagerphone.
No, fuck it. Oh, ooh. Sorry. No, you let's do that.
No. You'll offend Melanie's parents, though.
They've disowned her long ago, haven't they?
I vote for the tiger suit. That sounds great.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. Tiger suit. Yeah.
Or the tiger jacket. Oh, I didn't know you're a mandolin player, Melanie. Oh.
Dad put a beep in there for you. There you go. Don't beep. I don't know how to play it's a mandola, but I don't really know how to play it. I just write songs on it.
Oh, beautiful.
Oh.
That's a lovely
So then
mandola.
I just sort of find spots, find places for it to go, but I don't really know what my chords are. I'm just making up sounds, you know. So I'm going to play, I was going to play a kind of a sad one, but that's all right. Okay. I could do that. I'll do it. Yeah, okay, good. Because it's nice to pull this out. All right, I'll see you in a second. Actually, I'm not going to play that one. I'm going to play this one, Quiet Town. I've got to fit in the vibe, man. I can't just, like, jump out of it. So, here's Quiet Town. This is a Peter Coombs mandola. He's a local luthier.
Is he? Oh, that's beautiful.
The mandola's beautiful. I've got one that I got in Romania, but Kate, I think, in the New Graces, pulls faces every time I pull it out because it's really out of tune.
I think so there's a whole bunch of those Romanian ones that are not very good. So yes,
it's the one that gave me all the song. It gave me all the songs, so I love it so much. Even though it's a little bit like wonky, It's the perfect busking mandola.
All right. Because I'd like the slightly bigger one.
You don't want to take your fancy one with you.
Mandocello. No, I've got a Gilchrist, which is Steve Gilchrist down in Melbourne, mate. But back in the day, back in 1970-something, 76 or something.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah, so this is a song, this is an amusing song now, vaguely amusing song. And Dobe gets to play spoons.
But
you'll have to mute Dobe because it goes a bit out of time.
Yeah,
we'll
yeah.
Get the visual.
But Dobe.
We'll get the visual.
Get the visual, yeah. Hold them up so we can see them, Dobe.
Wait a minute. Where are they? Oh, here they are.
Oh, yes.
All right.
Dobe plays the spoons. It's is one of his major instruments. All Dobe's instruments together are worth about $300.
Look at that. Go.
Give us a little spoon solo for a bit there, Dobe. All right, that'll do.
Awesome.
I wrote this song. This very silly song when I was doing a lot of renovating, which seems to be just the story of my life if you've got an old house like we have. Sunday morning. Sorry, Mel, you're going to have to mute Dobe now.
Oh.
Hey. And just keep playing Dobe because it's great, but just the look of it. Sunday morning, lovely day. My wife says, "Darling, are you awake? Got a couple of things that I need done." Before I've even gotten a kiss, she hands me a massive list. Looks like I'll be heading off to Bunnings. "Well, darling, there's a leak somewhere. You said you'd fix that busted chair. By the way, the dryer's on its way out. It's not enough that I work all week. What about my Sunday treat? Now, off you go to Bunnings. Bunnings is a wonderland. Things to build and things to mend. A golden chance to spend. Treasure trove of files. Seems so simple, DIY. Then you go another trip to Bunnings. Well, I signed up for tiling classes. 20 blokes on frozen asses. Dreaming of a couch and the TV. I bought the stuff, I made mistakes. The ground looked like I'd iced a cake. I had to fix it with another trip to Bunnings. Then I bought a fancy barbecue. The box said not a lot to do. Half of it sat and made it out of china. Show figure 3 to section A. Then go and throw the box away. Another pricey wasted trip to Bunnings. Bunnings is a wonderland with things to build. Cement, golden chance to spend. Treasure trove of files. Seems so simple, DIY. Make your stuff and every time back you go. Another trip to Bunnings. There used to be a little guy who ran a store in the town. Tell him all my problems and he'd help me to sort them out. He never had the right thing. He never get it from another store. By the time it came, I couldn't think what I needed that thing for.
Hey! We'll be right back.
wife says, darling, you awake? Got a couple of things that I need done. I chuck her the credit card and I walk her sweetly to the car. Say, see you later, darling, have a lovely time at Bunnings. Cause Bunnings is a wonderland of things to build and things to mend. A golden chance to spend and spend and spend and spend and spend. Yes, it's a DIY, baby, stop it every time. Back you go, another trip to Bunnings. Yeah, back you go, another trip to Bunnings. See you later, darling, have a lovely day at Barney's. Bring me back a sausage.
Woo!
A very silly song, that one.
Well, it's today I went and got my jab, you know, and all the shops in Bega are closed, obviously, and I hadn't been out of the house for 2 weeks. I'd been very well behaved and staying inside my little house, but Mitre 10 was there, and I was like, "Don't go in, don't go in, don't go in." I would have bought some like. Yeah, I was going
to
buy poles and I was going to buy, like, garden things and I was just going to...
Yeah. Chicken wire and an azalea and...
And star pickets and it was all going to go into that landscape, so it was cool.
Well, we moved house about 3 or 4 years ago and we bought a 100-year-old house, you know, a Federation house, and it's, you know, it's been game on ever since. Luckily, we're about 10 minutes to Bunnings, so I'm there all the time.
Yeah, cool. I did think we could do like a muso stall at Bunnings. You know how like it's like sausages for different kinds of charities. I thought we could do a muso one.
Yeah, I don't know why they don't let people sing there and then, you know.
Yeah, we can't now, I suppose. Yeah, yeah. Not unless you're selling cookies or sausages, or I suppose.
But you know what, there's an 18-month waiting list.
Is it?
Oh, for those? Yeah, I imagine. Yeah.
Wow.
It's primo. It's primo sausage shilling territory.
Oh yeah, and you know the local scout group makes a lot of dough, but it's an 18-month waiting list at the Biggins.
Mm. Yes. Well. It is my favourite lunch. It's actually the only time my daughter comes to the hardware store with me is if I'm going to Bunnings, and I promise we'll buy her a sausage. So.
And the good news is that if you play the lagerphone, you have to go to Bunnings all the time.
It's your music store, isn't it?
It's my music store, exactly.
Hacksaws and hammers and screws
and
drills. Oh, and
a piece of dowel,
Tassie oak, I see specifically. Well, have you got, Dobe? I'm just checking in. Have we got...
It's like this.
Oh, yeah, okay.
That's the thing he hits the lagerphone with. And this will kill one blow from this and you'd be dead. So, you know, that's how hard he hits it. So,
goodness.
I know.
Is that why you've got it?
Yes, I keep it away from Dobe because he is in lockdown and we can't trust him.
But the sad part is, Mel, that I've hit myself on a number of occasions, but but worse than that, I've actually hit other members of the band.
we've had 100 people through our band as a result.
yeah. And look, I'm sorry about it, but it's
not
just,
not enough, that's for sure.
No, I know. But it's just, you know how music carries you away. You know, you just lose yourself in the music.
Bearings,
and all of a sudden somebody next door to you is bleeding. And you go, oh, sorry.
The worst one was, Mel, when we were playing at a bush dance at Centenary Hall back in the day, and there's like 2,000 people there or something, you know, massive things, and we're whipping ourselves up into a frenzy, and Dobe cuts himself with the metal parts on the lagerphone, cuts like an artery or something, and then he sprays blood all into the audience. It was like an Iggy Pop concert or something, an Alice Cooper concert. It was disgusting. Yeah. But, you know, they thought it was fantastic. It was the 70s. It was the 80s, actually, the early 80s.
Yeah.
Nobody cared.
Rock and roll.
I'm just checking rock and roll for sure.
Yeah.
Are we going to go round one more time after this, or is
sure.
just the...
Sure. Yep. Oh. That sounds good.
All right.
Yep. Okay, good. All right. So, Dobe, what you got for us now?
Well, have I got the song, Rog?
Yes, this is Dobe's last song.
All right.
Yep.
Well, you tell them and I'll plug all in right. the thing and
I'll
go.
Give you my standard rave about this song. Back in 1987, Dobe was very clever. He invited Bruce Woodley to his house from the Seekers because Bruce said, I've got this song and I wouldn't mind some Australian content for it. And the song turned out to be quite successful. And Dobe's been living off the proceeds ever since. That's why he appears to be living in this little kind of messy house there in Northcote. But in actual fact, most of the year is spent on the Bahamas with his loot from this song. So, because you know how much song.
Are you ready to go, Dobe?
Pays.
So great, yeah, I know. Great yeah, song. You can get like
millions.
Okay, I'm going to hand you over to Dobe. Ready?
All right, here he is.
I came upon a prison ship, bound down my iron chain. Cleared the land, endured the lash, and waited for the rains. I'm a settler, I'm a farmer's wife, on a dry and barren run. A convict, then a free man, I became Australian. And I'm the daughter of a digger, who sought the motherlode. The girl became a woman on the long and dusty road. I'm a child of the Depression, and I saw the good times come. I'm a bushy, I'm a battler, I am Australian. I'm a teller of stories, and I'm a singer of songs. I am Albert Namajira, and I paint the ghostly gums. I'm Clancy on his horse, I'm Ned Kelly on the run. Yes, I'm the one who was Matilda. I am Australian, for we are one, but we are many, and from all the lands on earth we come. We share a dream and sing with one voice. I am, you are, we are Australian. I'm the hot wind from the desert, I'm the black soil of the plains. I am the mountains and the valleys, the drought and flooding rains. I am the rock, I am the sky, the rivers are when they run. I am the spirit of this great land, I am Australian. And I came from the dreaming, from the dusty red soil plain. I am the ancient heart, the keeper of the flame. Stood upon this rocky shore, I watched the tall ships come, when for 50,000 years I'd been the first Australian. Well, we are one, but we are many, many, and from all the lands on earth we come. We share a dream and sing with one voice. I am, you are, we are Australia, for we are one, but we are many, and from all the lands on earth we come. We share a dream and sing with one voice. I am, you are, we are Australian.
Yay! Good boy, Dobe. Excellent work.
There you go, Shane.
Thanks, Shane. Lovely to see you. Haven't seen Shane for ages.
Yeah. When you really think about it, we didn't get it. Oh, actually, my mate Tommy's joined in from New Zealand. That's lovely. G'day, Tommy.
Oh, that's nice.
And now here you go, Julie from South Sydney Folk Club.
Well, that's right. We are booked to the South Sydney Folk Club. If we can possibly make it to come there, we just don't know if Victoria will let Dobe out. So we'll have to see. Well, they might let him out. They just won't let him back in.
Hang on a minute. New South Wales, no thank you.
Oh, come on now, Dobe.
Well, don't put shit on Victoria.
No, I'm just saying that we could probably get you out of Victoria, but we couldn't get you back in.
No.
You couldn't get you back in again. It's funny because I at this beautiful, beautiful tour that I really wanted to do came up for Queensland, and it's going to be in October, but I kind of said to them, well, geez, I really want to do it, but I reckon that you might need a Queensland artist because I don't think they'll let me out. So just, you know, even if, you know, we winged it, it would just be, I think it's silly. I just have to sit here in the house for a while.
We're all going to be sitting in our houses and doing lots more of this, Melanie. So that's
we just got to write more songs. Let's write heaps of songs. I think last year my songwriting brain was a bit bollocks, and now it's good. Go on, Dobe.
I was just going to say before we go, thanks for this, Mel. This is great that you're doing it. And well done you.
Ah, thank you. Thanks for joining me. I'm in the company of rock stars.
Oh, yeah, right. Where else are we going to go?
Come on. And... thank you very much. I'm going to... I thought I'd play a banjo song and we'll go back to you, Roger, and then... Then that's the end of the night, which is sad.
We've loved it. And we're already at an hour and a half, so there you go.
I know. See, we've been missing partying. This is what we got.
Yeah.
See, I'll see you in a second. I could do this one.
Okay.
Hang on. my headband. I never wear headbands. Why would you wear a headband and headphones? That's silly. But look, it's all twinkly. See? My daughter put it on me so that I'm more twinkly this evening. All right. The other one. So here's a song called Midnight Mermaid Blue. Once again, I don't know how to play the banjo either. I just wrote this song on it, so that's what happened. It's hard to follow up after a Dobe song. Dark night, how do I honor you? Star so bright, whisper moon. Drove home, the sky flew with sea green, variations on a theme. Nine, catching treasures above the deep inside of me. Give me a line, I'll go fishing. What's unseen from this perspective? Everything shimmering, sunlight on my skin, shade to
play that.
I can play these chords.
Yeah.
Are they banjo chords?
So that particular song I wrote in the car park of the Girl Guides. You know, when you have to put the girls into guides, and then you have to wait in the car for an hour and a half. So I got my How to Play Banjo book, and I learnt three chords, and then that song appeared. So they're real chords, not made-up chords. There you go.
Yes. I remember dropping Lily at Guides, and little people guides.
Yeah. Oh, someone raised, whatever happened to, someone's asked you a question. Carmen asked a question.
Oh. Yes, Stuart Watson. He played with Bulla McCanker, actually. Didn't play with us.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. There you go, Carmen.
Yeah. And I don't know where he is now.
And Shane's hopped in there.
Hey, Roger, do you remember when you played the Pendle Hill Catholic Club way back in the late 80s? Yes, I do. And some the two marks still come out from there who are now old guys when they were 18-year-olds back then. And they used to, and they still come to our Anzac Day show at Blacktown every year. Saw them this year. And we're all getting a little bit older. Well, they are, but I'm not, but they are.
It's like, when you said that line, when you said that line, all I can think is, we're all getting a little bit older. I just thought, there's a song there, right? There's always a song like that.
we're all getting a little bit older. And you get older and older through the song, through the whole thing. Start saying, we're all getting a little bit older. Yeah. Okay, good idea, Mel. Yeah. I'll write it tomorrow.
Rog.
Yes, Dobe. Yes, Dobe.
I'll be on mute now, so what are you going to play?
I'm going to play The Good Old Days, Dobe, because I thought that would be a jolly way to finish.
Well, seeing nobody can hear what I'm doing, I thought I might go and get the lagerphone and play that.
Why not?
Well, you know, seeing nobody's going to be able to hear it.
Yeah, it'll just tie yourself out, though.
It'll be visually vaguely appealing. Entertaining.
Yes, I'd say knock yourself out, but you probably will.
Ha, ha, ha. All right, well, thanks. Mel.
Thank you. Get the lagerphone and we'll see you in a second.
I can't wait till the New Graces and the Bushwackers go out and do a whole bunch of shows together. That'd be
mad.
That'd be great, actually. I was seriously thinking about it. But I think you're too famous now, so.
You know, no.
I have to wait till you're on the down part of your career.
Already. Here you go. Sam said that she's looking forward to Dobe. It'll be visually spectacular. Perfect. Jacket, how good's the jacket?
I know. Nice. That's one of those mild, that's one of his mild jackets.
No. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
It's got a lot of stupid clothes though.
It's a beauty. It's fantastic.
So we're gonna do the lagerphone. Oh my god. What could go wrong?
No, you just...
Well, actually, Dobe, if you put it on the speakers, we can mute you and you can dance around. Well, this is the last song, everybody, so, you know, we'll write back to you in the comments afterwards. If we've missed anything, we can say hello to you and... everybody and, join in on conversations that we've missed because we don't get everything on this stream on the right. You might have missed something, so all good.
Hi, Craig. Thanks, folks, for the most entertaining Saturday night I've had for a while.
Beauty.
That's good. Yes.
Oh, there he is. Look at that.
It's the most entertaining night I've had for a while.
Oh, perfect. What a shot.
Thank you so much, Melanie, for organising this. We've been very honoured to be here with you and have a date night with you.
Me too. Thank you.
This is called
dance.
The Good
I'm
Old Days.
Here and dance.
All right. This is about growing up in Australia. Do the When we were young, we played footy in the street. The house was always full of kids. Nobody knew where the hell we all were. Nobody knew what we did. We rode our bikes all over the world. We hang out at the beach or the park. They'd never ask, we'd never say, long as we are home before dark. Some nights my dad would turn and say, say these are the good old days. They're the good old days. These are the good old days. They're the good old days. These troubled times, they're the good old days. Well, at 21, we had no mobiles or emails. We all seen and managed just fine. Over in town, getting wild and crazy. Somehow most of us survived. But we fell in love. We got ourselves jobs. We were all just living the dream. We had kids, cars, house in the suburbs. Life was meant to be easy, it seemed. One night I heard somebody say, somebody say, these are the good old days. They're the good old days. These are the good old days. They're the good old days. These troubled times are the good old days. In a few years' time, I'll be having a beer. We'll be laughing as the sun goes down. I'll look over at you and I'll smile and say, remember that year with COVID? Remember when fuel was just $1.45? We could still lie in the sun. We could live, love, work and dream. And there was hope for everyone. I say these are the good old days. The good old days. These are the good old days. Good old days, these troubled times, these frustrating times, these worrying times, they're the good old days, they're the good old days, the good old days, the good old days. Everybody, happy Saturday. See you all soon.
Thanks, everyone. Good night.